So this is my old 3D printer. I've had this thing for about 7 years and I've printed a lot of things with it. Everything from tools to parts for cars and small parts for cars, of course. And naturally things to improve the printer. It's now getting a little tired, to say the least, and dated. You can see some of the rails have started to rust there. And when you plug it in, the screen's burnt out. I used it in anger about probably 2 months ago, and it still worked okay then. But things have improved. It's always concerned me with these printers. You can see the hotbed connector there. This is what's called a bed slinger type printer, and that is a point which gets hot. I've had my thermal camera on that, and it gets very hot and I think quite dangerous because it's fairly high amps. Anyway, I think it's time for retirement. And this is my new 3D printer. It's a Bambu Labs P1S Combo. The combo part refers to the four colour feeder at the top there. I've printed what they call a poop chute at the side here. But yes, it's a vast improvement. I've already printed a fair bit with it and tested it, and I'm very happy. I could have gone with the X1 carbon, but which is the top of the range for the Bambu printers. But that was nearly $1,000 more expensive, even on sale. That's $1,000 Australian, of course. So I don't really think there was much extra value in that. It has another sensing system, the X1 carbon, and also a better screen. But in practice, you don't really use the screen because it's driven by software on your PC or on your phone. You can send files directly to the printer, even remotely, out on the road, and it'll print at home for you. So that's working well. Anyway, I'll show you what I've been printing. So that was done using non-bamboo PLA, some old PLA I had lying around. A little bit furry, but really not terrible. First ever print. So I've been making things with 3D printer. This remote had lost its back a long time ago. So I made one. Could do with another print, really, because it's not 100%, but I'm not doing any more. I already can see there, I already did one prototype, but it does fit. It's in, it doesn't clip in, that's the problem. So nothing a bit of blue tap wouldn't fix, eh? But yeah, good old Fusion 360. And you can see that's my attempt at a clip, but this is strange on this remote control. It doesn't actually have a ledge for it to latch into. Anyway, that's that. And then this I liked because it's one of those print-in-place things. This is just ordinary shiny black PLA, but that hinge, I don't know if you can see that. Possibly not. Yeah, that hinge you print in place, so it's not assembled, it comes straight off the hot plate and works, which I couldn't do on my old 3D printer anyway. So that's just for holding cables together, that's all that's for. And I also printed this. This is actually a desiccant holder for the printer. You need to dry the filament as well as possible, so put your desiccant in there and it dries it. It's printed well. If you look closely, you can see the layers are
This is actually in matte PLA, which I think probably prints better than ordinary glossy PLA. Nice clear print, and the lid works. That's better. Now it slides in. And actually it's on a ridge.
So the printer working hard here. Got the door open because this is PLA and you want it to cool quicker. But that's printing 10 of my little socket blocks. That's just in 100% mode. You can go faster than that, but gives better quality, I think.
And that's it completed. I wanted something to hold my socket torque bits. They're 3/8 and they fit in there. The first one I did, which was this, goes in but too tight. There you go. So what I did was, those completely bespoke, I just made them. So they're made like that. So you can have it make any shape using the little, those little things that I printed. And you've just got a slot. It slots into that. You could glue them up, but I probably won't. Anyway, that was one of my first trials. And these are just some vacuum cleaner adapters. I'll probably do a video on the design process for these. Anyway, please like and subscribe, and I'll do some more content soon. Thanks.